Aloha, I'm Jay Fadden. Thank you so much for joining us today on This Is The Day, joined by my great friends Kevin Elson and Bishop Reed. And Bishop, we have a very, very special show today.
We certainly do. We're on the island of Oahu in Hawaii. We're going to be talking today about two venerable saints to the native people here in Hawaii. And also we're going to have a chat with the Bishop of the Diocese of Honolulu, Bishop Larry Silva.
Oh, that and so much more. It's going to be a wonderful show from Oahu. Stay tuned. This Is The Day starts right now.
Aloha, aloha, aloha. I'm Jay Fadden, joined by my great friends Kevin Elson and Bishop Reed. And of course, you at home, and you probably can see from behind us that we are in beautiful Hawaii. And the reason that we are here is because we have a number of viewers who write into us from Hawaii. And we want to show the universal church. And we met a lot of those viewers, Bishop, when you did the Sunday Mass recently.
I was very honored by the rector of the Cathedral of Our Lady of Peace, Father Pasquale, Bishop Larry Silva, to celebrate the 10 o'clock Mass. And as you say, there was a great number of our viewers who came, who watch on KUPU TV and also online. It was wonderful to meet them. They came bearing gifts, and actually we're wearing some of them right now.
Yeah, Kevin, you have one, and Sister was so kind. She gave us the shirts, which mine did not fit, so that's why I don't have one. And of course, a book.
Yeah, Sister Davalin, I hope I said that right, but she was just wonderful. She gave us these beautiful Hawaiian shirts with St. Marian and St. Damian on them as well. And she had written a book with another sister called A Walk with St. Marian Cope. So we have those as well. Very nice. Just one of the many nice people that we've met here during the course of our stay. It's just incredible the amount of hospitality that has been shown to us, and really appreciate it.
Yeah, the people are awesome. They are just awesome here. They've been so good to us. It's a wonderful atmosphere. And, you know, Bishop, we're not just doing This Is The Day. You've done a couple of things. What have you done so far? What are we going to see back on Catholic TV?
We're going to be praying the rosary as we do every day on Catholic TV, but from various sites around the island of Oahu. In very beautiful sites, because it's hard to find a place that isn't. We're going to also record the Divine Mercy Chaplet in the Cathedral of Our Lady of Peace. And that's to say nothing of Kevin's work for Catholic Destinations.
Yeah, what did you do for Catholic Destinations?
Yeah, well, we did a destination, Jay. We went to the Cathedral Basilica of Our Lady of Peace.
See that about 3 or 4 years?
Yeah. And we're at the, just the many different places that we, as you're mentioning too, we're standing right here at the Makapupu lookout, and it's just a wonderful sight behind us. It's unbelievable. So we're traveling around, we're doing some reflections, as Bishop Reed said he's doing, and the Catholic Destination as well. We're going to be actually stopping by the USS Missouri to do a special show there. So many different.
So it's really beautiful behind us. They won't let me turn around to look. They just stuck me out here. Is it really pretty?
Yeah.
I gotta compliment you guys. Your Hawaiian is awesome.
Okay, mine is terrible. All right, no, really, it is, and
aloha,
I know it is.
Aloha was good at the beginning.
Well, it's aloha. If I mess that up, then we're in big trouble. So we did a thing on the telethon where we tried to do the names, and we all tried. How did you do? Did you do pretty good?
I did 50-50.
How did you do?
I don't know, actually.
Probably not.
I know.
I was the worst.
Yeah.
And it's gotten worse since I've been here for some reason, which I cannot believe.
They still love you, Jay.
Well, if you get this, you have the copy of this book, Jay. I want to point you. There's a Hawaiian language guide right
I saw
here.
That.
Yeah, you can take a look. And
it didn't help me.
Study that
up there. Yeah.
Yeah, no, none of that helped me at all. I mean, it was. So far, what would you say has been the highlight for you? Because we have a lot more to go. What's been your highlight, Bishop?
Well, I've never been, first of all, to an island. I've never been to Hawaii or the island of Oahu, so it's all new to me. It's extremely beautiful everywhere you go. It's almost like paradise. In fact, that's why we're also doing a series of short videos on beauty and how we find God and the beauty of this incredible planet, this world of ours. But I got to say, the greatest beauty of all are the people. So friendly, so hospitable, and our viewers have welcomed us with open arms, because we have so many people here, as I say, that enjoy Catholic TV In Hawaii.
Yeah, and we're going to hopefully bring you on a tour a little bit of Hawaii. This is my first time here, too. I've never been to Hawaii as well. So I know it's your second time because you came on your honeymoon.
That's right.
So we want to bring in you guys a little bit of Hawaii ourselves. So we hope you can see that. How about you? Highlight so far?
Yeah, just traveling around, as Bishop Reed saying, meeting the people, just talking to some of the people that came to the Mass and the distance they traveled and the love they have for Catholic TV is very humbling to see and to talk to these people too. And, you know, get people walking up, giving you gifts and things like that. It's just amazing.
Oh, you got gifts?
Yeah.
Did you get gifts?
I got a couple, yeah.
Not like you. You've been getting gifts left and right.
All right.
Well, I'm going to go to the next thing.
Yeah, you got to go.
I've got
you got a great place. Go ahead. Tell them.
Who did that interview?
You let people know.
So we are now going to the Damien and Marian of Molokai Education Center. And it happens that Kevin Nelson did that interview. Let's take a look.
Joining us now on our special edition of This is the Day in Hawaii, we have Father Lane Akiona. Thank you so much for being with us, Father.
Thank you. Good to be here.
And we are in the Damien and Marian, the Molokai Education Center, and it's a beautiful place. And maybe if you could tell us a little bit about this and how this sort of all came to fruition and as we progress in the building of this up.
Thank you. Yes. The idea came about 2008, just before Damien was to be canonized, and we were frantically moving around. Well, what do we do now? We have to present something for people who want to know about Damien. And so the idea came, we should build a center. Basically, it was a museum, what we're looking at. And then it just evolved into what it is now. But the purpose was to share with people the life of Damien and the work that he did in Kalawao and Kalapapa on Molokai.
And as we have this center right now too, and maybe if you could talk about the stages and the hopes as you go through this now, because you have everything sort of here based and ready to take the next step.
Yes. Before COVID hit us in 2019, we're ready to launch a major fundraiser to complete the exhibits and the displays portion. Because of those 2 years, we're not able to fundraise. And so basically, we're fundraising to make that a reality. We have all the artifacts that we need, all the display information, the audio equipment that we needed, all of that, the lighting. So it's all ready, except for the internal aspects of the center. And so we're hoping that we're able to raise it within the next year or so, and then hopefully by next year we'll be able to open up again to the public.
Talk about the importance of this center, of getting the story of Damien and Marian out to people, and you know how important that is.
I think for us in Hawaii and for a member of the congregation with the Sacred Hearts, it is our legacy. Our brother came in service to the Native Hawaiian people. And in doing that, the disease spread. And then he shifted his focus that he wanted to be of greater assistance to those who are stricken. And so he befriended a local Protestant doctor who taught him some of the finer things about medicine and how to care for people. And so when the call came out for someone to go to Kalawao, he was the first to volunteer, and the rest is history. I think for us, Damien was the model that teaches us of that selfless giving so that others may feel that they are valued by God and that they're loved by God as well too. So,
And for people to learn about this story too, and I know talking to you too, you want to
showcase some of the people that were on Kalaupapa 2, and the people that had Hansen's disease and leprosy, and how important their stories are too to be included in this museum, education center.
I think, at least from my perspective, if there was no leprosy or disease, then saints would not rise to the forefront. But that's exactly what happened. And Damien and Marianne heard the call, and they were more than willing to come and do what they could to help people. And now the focus we have is to focus on those whom they cared for, because definitely we know that they have family members living today who want to connect with those loved ones that they never knew that was in Kalaupapa and Kalawao as well too. So that's our challenge, is making that connection.
And it's beautiful center too. And maybe if you could talk about where we're standing in, and you talked about this church and how important this church is.
In Kalawao, the St. Filomena's was a small chapel, and Damien set out to enlarge in it because the numbers had increased. And so this is a replica of the inside of that chapel, not exactly as it is, but very similar to it. So I think when the architect and I talked about a space that would not necessarily be a church, but at least a quiet place for reflection and meditation for people, after seeing the exhibits and the displays, contemplate us to look at the deeper thought that went on in their lives and how they were able to serve.
And I know you're the provincial of the order that St. Damien was a part of as well. What does that mean to you to be a part of this and to try to continue St. Damien's legacy here?
For me as provincial, I think we carry that legacy of service to the people today in the 21st century, and what a challenge it is. Right here in Waikiki, we have a large homeless populace, you know, and very often society and leaders want to just push them aside and not be seen. But the reality is they are seen, and to carry on the legacy of Damien and Marianne, to provide food for them is just one component. And in serving them with food, there are other components that we're able to help them in as well, too.
And as we wrap up this talk, but maybe if you could talk to about what people can do, what to help with this this education center, maybe how they can find out more about this wonderful place.
I think first and foremost is to pray, you know, that our saints who intercede for our causes to help make their message much more real for people today, but also financial support as well, so that we can complete the projects that we've want to complete, so that we can open our doors and continue sharing the story. We do have a website on St. Augustine's, and you could probably get more information from there as well too, for donations online. So
that's great. Well, thank you so much, Father Lane, for talking to us. We appreciate it. We're going to send it back to the rest of This Is the Day.
And a special thanks to Father Lane for allowing us to go down there. And I was very impressed that not only do they have the Damien and Marianne Education Center, but they also help the homeless there too.
Absolutely. It was wonderful to see, actually, as we were leaving, the homeless were coming in. They were giving them a warm meal, great hospitality, even for the poor.
Yeah, St. Augustine's by the Sea Church, right there, right on Waikiki Beach. So it looks like it's going to be a beautiful center. Once they get all the exhibits in there, it's going to be a great place. And people will walk. There's so much traffic down there. People just walking by and happen to see that, you know, we'll come in and learn a little bit more about two great saints here.
You know what I was really impressed by, too? Travis moving the statues in there, because they were these wood statues. They were as big as you, but bigger. And he did a good job. What do we have next?
We're going to go. Bishop Silva was very gracious, and I actually interviewed him for the Catholic Destinations, but he also allowed us to interview him and talk a little bit about the diocese with Bishop Reed as well. So let's take a look at that right now.
Well, as promised, Bishop Larry Silver is our guest today with Hawaiian family roots. He spent many years as a priest in the Diocese of Oakland. And now, since 2005, the Bishop of Honolulu, Father Larry Silva. So great to have you with us today.
Thank you. Aloha and welcome to you.
Thank you. Mahalo. So you have roots here. You love the people in these islands, I know, because we've talked. Tell us about the diocese and the wonderful people here.
Yes. Well, it's a very diverse diocese. We have, you know, people from all over Asia. We have, you know, mostly Filipinos. We have, you know, people from all over the world. It's a very strategic place in the Pacific. And so we have a lot of military here, too. And so it's a great diocese. People are very involved. There's a real family spirit among people. And, you know, help one another when there are needs. Of course, we have six islands where there are parishes. And so we have to, you know, go from island to island to minister to those folks as bishop and visit them. And every island is a little bit different, but they all are feel like they're one family, you know.
Wonderful people. That's been my experience. And I know you know that probably better than most. And we're standing here in your cathedral, the Mother Church of the Diocese of Honolulu. I can see your chair, your cathedra, right in my line of sight. Mm-hmm. And this is a very special place. It's history, the fact that it's a basilica. Could you help us to understand better why this is such an important location?
It's important because it was kind of a celebration of religious freedom. When right after Catholicism was outlawed in Hawaii for 10 years, and the king gave the land to the Catholic Church, and they built this cathedral, the people built this cathedral. Father Damien of Molokai was ordained here at this cathedral, had his first mass here. When St. Marianne Cope came to Hawaii with her sisters, this is the first place that they came for Mass of Thanksgiving. We have their relics here, the body of St. Marianne. And so it's a very historic place. It's a center of, you know, our faith and culture. We have our Red Mass every year for the opening of the legislature. We have, you know, many, many events here. Tomorrow we'll be having a priest funeral, someone who's been a priest here for about 70 years. And so it really is the center of the diocese.
And you were instrumental in the canonization process for these two marvelous saints. It's been an honor for me to venerate their relics. And it's quite unusual for two saints in a diocese, is it not?
Yes, it is. And I was privileged to be the bishop when both of them were canonized. Now, I can't really say that I had much to do with their canonizations, except the celebrations of their canonizations. The work had already been done before I got here, and so I just kind of got to celebrate. You know?
And the Catholic community here on the islands is relatively young, relatively new. The Congregation of the Sacred Hearts of Jesus and Mary were the missionaries who came, right?
They were the missionaries who came in 1827, and they are still here, still growing. I'll be ordaining a priest for them who's one of our men. He grew up here in Hawaii. You know, they're still growing and still working here.
Walking around the cathedral, too, I see that there's a renovation process.
Yes.
How's that coming along?
Well, it's coming along slowly but surely. We've been working on it for a number of years. The cathedral was built in 1843, and it's been renovated a number of times over that period of time, but it lately has been neglected, and so we're really trying to restore it and trying to give it the feel of what it would have been when St. Damien and St. Marianne were here worshiping.
And before we let you go, I just want to know just from you personally, having spent your early years here in Hawaii, what's it like to be the bishop of these islands and these wonderful people?
Well, I'm very privileged because my family has long roots here in Hawaii, 150 years. And I was born here, but raised in California. My parents moved there when I was a year old. But we always had Hawaii in our culture, you know, the foods and the, I could pronounce the place names, which some people find challenging. It was always a second home to me when I was in California, and then it got to be my first home. So I'm very blessed to be here.
And we're blessed to have come to know you and to experience your hospitality and that of the Hawaiian people, and also to learn where to go for Malasadas. It's Leonard's,
right? Amen. Leonard's.
So whenever anybody comes to Hawaii, you got to go to Leonard's at least once for the Malasadas. Yes. Bishop Silva, thank you
so
much for your time.
Thank
you. God bless you and your ministry here.
Blessings to you too.
Thank you. And we're going to go back now to more of This Is the Day.
So we're on the island of Oahu, Hawaii, and we have to, so many people have told me about Leonard's Bakery. Leonard's Bakery, get the malasadas. So that's where we are. We're here right now, and I think we're going to try it. Are you guys excited?
I am starving. Excited? I'm just hungry. And it has some Portuguese connections, too, because malasadas, I've had that at Portuguese festivals and stuff.
Oh, yeah, yeah. 1952 it was started. Jay?
1952.
Mr. Foodie?
Yeah, here it is. Here's what I want to do. It's got to be plain, okay? Cinnamon plain, or just plain, okay? Nothing crazy, all right?
No filling, right, no.
So you're going to get it?
So I think I'll get the original, and I'll get the cinnamon.
I want cinnamon.
Okay, all right, and then we'll try them out here and see what you think.
Is there sugar on it, too?
Oh, plenty of sugar.
Ooh, we like the sugar.
It's sweet.
There's a lot of sugar.
Sugar and dough, good
for
you.
Won't be taking my nap today.
All right, let's go in and get some.
All right.
I'm hungry.
I'm starving. I washed my hands and everything.
Ooh. Oh, you're ready to go.
Fresh.
Are there still six in there?
There's six in there.
Because you took a long time. I think you might eat inside.
Actually, very warm.
These are warm.
Let me open them up and we could take a peek inside there. Look at those.
Show us.
We got the three cinnamon and three sugars. How do you want to start?
I'm
going to start with the cinnamon.
Yeah.
Bishop Reed.
Oh, it's squishy.
Ooh. Yeah. Here, let's give you a napkin here.
My gosh.
Here's a napkin for you, Bishop.
This is a good reason to come to Hawaii.
So how did
just
you...
for Leonard's.
How did you say that? I'm saying malasadas, but you added like a little more of an accent.
Malasadas.
Malasadas. Malasadas.
You don't want to know how I would say it?
What do you think?
It's delicious.
Mr. Guy that's
I really like this. This is something I could eat.
This is unbelievable.
Of course, it's bread and cinnamon. Mm-hmm.
If it wasn't 85 degrees out, I'd have a nice hot coffee with this.
I know. Well, you always have coffee. Now I know why people come here.
Oh, yeah.
This is really good.
Leonard's.
Mm-hmm. Leonard's Bakery since 1952. So this is a cinnamon one. The originals have just sugar on it.
Didn't your mother ever tell you not to talk with your mouth full?
I know, that's good. Anybody say that.
You all ate cinnamon ones?
Yeah,
I'm going to take a second one.
Well, you're going to have the sugar one.
I'll have a plain one. I don't want yours.
This is just one of the many authentic Hawaiian places that you had to finish. You had to stop by. Help me out. Stop eating.
Oh. I can't help you.
I'm so excited about the food. I can't speak.
I'm not spinning because I just keep eating the food. Come to Hawaii, go to Leonard's, eat malasadas with cinnamon. Mm.
We'll have more from Hawaii.
Thanks to Bishop Silver and to the Damien and Marion.
Now you just did what I would do occasionally too. You just threw in an R there on Bishop Silver.
Silver? Yeah. No, that's just
because we don't use ours in Boston, so I figured I'd just throw an extra one in. I mean, doesn't that make sense?
We're giving a local flavor here. That's what it's all about.
I can't say any of the names, so I might as well not be able to say any names of anyone. And now I'm going to try this, okay? So the Damien and Marion of Molokai Education Center, we'd like to thank them.
Father Lane. Yes, thank you.
Yep. Out there. Kev, what has been, beyond, you know, all the church events and all the shooting, what's been your favorite place to go in Hawaii?
Just spending time with you guys. That's all that mattered to me. What it is.
Besides that, where have you been that you went, wow?
I think everywhere I've been to on this island is a wow thing, too. But, yeah, you're driving around. You know what's funny, too? I wanted to ask a local this, too. Do they ever get sick of rainbows? Because there's a rainbow every day.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
It's amazing.
Bishop Reed has yet to see a rainbow.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
So far, every day, I've seen a rainbow.
It's going to be the last day for me, I think.
I've seen about 8. By the way, talking about driving, Richard Brown has been critiquing your driving. Is it hard to drive with him?
I feel sorry for his wife who has to drive with him. He's notorious for that. Yeah, he's a backseat driver in the front seat, which is never a good thing.
And what's been your favorite place that has not been?
I got to tell you, honestly, guys, I mean, everywhere we go, like Kevin said, it's beautiful, but it was meeting the people. Particularly, I celebrated, as you mentioned before, the 10 o'clock Mass at the Cathedral of Our Lady of Peace. And meeting the people, our viewers, their hospitality, their love, they had gifts for us. They just love Catholic TV and they love their faith. The Catholic faith is alive and well on the Hawaiian Islands, and it's amazing to see. And I think that's the thing that I will remember the most about this incredible trip.
I would say my favorite place was Starbucks. I really thought it was so beautiful.
Get out of here. You don't even drink coffee.
We went to a trail, and it's a rainforest, and it was unbelievable.
Oh, I saw the pictures.
But like you, I think it really was the people. The people here have been extraordinary and so kind to us, so we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. And know that all of you, every single one of you, whether you be in Hawaii or anywhere else Catholic TV is, you're in our thoughts and in our prayers.
And as we kind of sadly conclude this very special, this is the day on the island of Oahu in Hawaii. We ask God to give you his blessings, particularly in this moment, which is difficult for the human family, that God might give you his strength and give our world peace, tranquility. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. St. Damien and St. Marian of Molokai,
pray for us.
Mahalo.